The last question is also the question that you answered in the book, Because of a Teacher. Now, I'm going to read the very first paragraph. So the last question is, what advice would you give to your first year teacher self? I think this ties in beautifully. We've all experienced significant moments in time that have transformed our perspectives and altered the paths we walked. These significant moments often engender a multitude of feelings that encourage us to make choices that impact the direction of our lives. These moments can be difficult to see in real time because we become so consumed with the experience itself. Awesome first paragraph. And you can read more and Because of a Teacher. So just look for it. You'll see in the links below. So Lauren, go a little bit deeper into that. So like you think about yourself as a first year teacher, especially with all the learning that's happening right now, what advice would you give to yourself, you know, if you can go back in time?
Gosh, there's so much advice. And when you asked me to write this chapter, I kept thinking about how can I capture everything I want to say in one chapter? Mm-hmm. Because to be honest with you, I feel like the way I lead and the way I have been on this educational journey is I look at every year as a first year. Mm-hmm. You know, that's how I stay on the cutting edge of best practice. That's how I become better. That's how I can elevate others and make them better. So what are some of the things I think about? Always keep kids at the heart of decision making. That's why we're here. It always comes back to kids, right? So we can differ in our perspectives. We can have different approaches to teaching and learning or management of the classroom or building a classroom community. But if kids are at the center of the conversation and you use the children to guide you in everything you do, you really can't go wrong. You know, get to know your learners. That's another piece of advice. You know, yes, there's a curriculum to cover, there's a scope and sequence, but the significant learning happens when you're connecting to the hearts and minds of children. They want to know that you care about them. When they know you care about them, they will work for you, mm-hmm. and in meaningful ways too. So that would be another one. Seek out professional learning opportunities. That's another big one. I think when I was a younger teacher, I used to kind of wait for them to come to me, like, oh, my school district will provide those opportunities for me. And that happens. Yes, school districts do that. But because we have different learners in front of us every year and we work with different colleagues and things are constantly evolving in the educational landscape that we live in, seek those opportunities out. You know, if you know your learners and you're able to notice and name their needs, then find those opportunities that are going to benefit you and your students. That looks different for everyone, just like success looks different for everyone. That's another piece of advice. Don't compare yourself to other people.
Right.
Theodore Roosevelt said, you know, comparison is the thief of joy. Once you start doing that, your mind starts running wild. It's like you look at the glass half empty. What is it that I'm not doing instead of all the amazing things that you are doing? Use the room to share ideas. Don't be afraid to ask for support. Find that network of support. There are always going to be people around you who have amazing strengths and will be there to support you. Get to know that community. Get to know who you can go to for help. And also, even if you find an interaction with someone who you're around to be unfavorable, maybe you're not enjoying that, that's something to learn from too.
Right.
So capitalize on those moments as well.